performance. It's what I'm super excited about, because tonight we're going to do all we can to connect music to reading. And I think that's perfect. I think that's perfect for a first grade music program. As kids are developing this love of reading, it's so fun to link that to a love of music. And so you're going to see all the books up here that will be performed by your kids. Except for the first one. The first one is called the Goldilocks Quartet. And today we are joined by students from Zionsville High School who are helping us. Now the kids have not gotten to see this book. This book is the surprise book of the evening. And I hope that we can bring it to life a little bit through music. Goldilocks walked by a charming little house every day. She loved it because it was a musical house. Day or night, she would hear beautiful music coming from inside. She often imagined what the inside looked like. She knew three bears lived there, Papa, Mama, and Baby. Goldilocks dreamed of saying hello, but she was always too shy. One day, she decided to be brave and introduce herself. She knocked on the door, and then again, loudly. The second time, the door opened by itself. Curiously, she couldn't hear any music. She wondered if anyone was home. Quietly, Goldilocks tiptoed inside. She found herself in a quaint kitchen full of handmade furniture. There was a table and three chairs, each one a different size. On the table were three bowls of porridge, but she walked past them. She was not sure she should be there when the bears weren't home. I'll look around their house quickly. They won't even know I was here, she thought. When Goldilocks left the kitchen, she found a cozy living room with three comfy chairs. She spotted a handmade table nearby with three small music players. She decided to listen to each one to learn what kind of music the bears enjoyed. The first player, Papa's, played the music by Joseph Haydn, nicknamed Papa Haydn by his students. When she pressed play, she heard a minuet, a type of dance. This is pretty, Goldilocks thought, but I want to hear something a little more exciting. Mama's music was composed by Dvorak. As Goldilocks listened, she imagined traveling by train. Baby's music. Hooray, she exclaimed, clapping her hands. It's a little night music by Mozart. This is my favorite piece of music. I don't have much time. I need to explore the rest of the house, Goldilocks decided. She brought Baby's music player with her so she could listen to his music. Soon, she found the bear's music room. Three instruments were lined up against the wall with a name tag for each bear. Papa's instrument was the largest of the three. It was called the cello. Goldilocks tried to pick it up, but it was too long. The sound was low, rich, and very beautiful. Mama's instrument, a viola, was smaller than Papa's. It had a beautiful, warm sound. But as Goldilocks Giraffes played, her arms started to sink. The viola was too heavy for her to play. As she struggled to hold it up, one of the strings snapped. Oh no, she cried out. She carefully put the viola away in the hope Mama wouldn't notice. Finally, Goldilocks picked up Baby's violin. The sound was clear and beautiful, as though the violin was singing. She was about the same size as Baby, so the violin felt just right. Through the window, Goldilocks saw there was a small stage in the garden with three music stands. She walked outside to see what kind of music the bears were studying. Baby's violin was still in her hand. She looked at Papa's music, but it was low and slow and a little boring. She tried to read Mama's music, but it was impossible. Mama did not usually get the melody, so it was very difficult to play. Finally, she sat down at Baby's music stand and she saw music by Beethoven, her favorite composer. She practiced Baby's music all afternoon, forgetting that she should leave before the bears got home. Meanwhile, humming a melody, the bears returned home after hearing a wonderful concert in the village. They were shocked to see their front door was open. "Someone's inside our house," Mama asked. The bears ran inside, past the uneaten board. They rushed straight for their musical instruments. Papa looked at his cello. "Who's been playing my instrument?" Mama cried, "Who snapped a string on my instrument?" Baby wailed, "Someone's taken my instrument and my music player." The bears were upset. Growling, they hurried through the house, determined to catch the musical. They rushed outside and found Goldilocks, practicing the violin with her eyes closed and a small smile on her face. They were enchanted by her beautiful music, and their anger melted away. As Goldilocks finished playing, she opened her eyes and saw the bears. Blushing, she walked up to them slowly. "I'm so sorry. I came to visit, and you were not home. I searched inside to find the instruments that made such beautiful music." Smiling, she looked at the violin in her hands and gave it to Baby. "I'm guessing this is yours." Papa and Baby forgave her. Mama even gave Goldilocks her old violin. It was perfect for Goldilocks. And that's where our story begins. The bears, who used to play music as a three-person trio, asked Goldilocks to join them and form a quartet. Every day after school, Goldilocks would visit her friends to practice, and they got better and better. When Baby and Goldilocks were old enough, they all traveled the world as the Goldilocks Quartet. They performed everywhere, from gorgeous halls holding thousands to tiny classrooms, just like yours. Before every performance, they would look at each other and smile, remembering the special day and the music that had brought them together. And they lived musically. Yes.
Does anyone have a tissue for me?
Right, happy sound.
Kiddos, are you ready?
Yeah.
Parents, this is good news and bad news told to you and played by Mrs. Renard's class. Once upon a time, there was a bunny and a nut.
One day, a bunny found a picnic basket. That's good news.
One of the other classes.
grass and daisies so that they can eat, and get fat. But on the way up there was a bridge over a rushing river. And under the bridge was a troll who was as mean as was ugly. First, the youngest Billy Goat Gruff decided to cross the bridge. One, two, ready, go.
It is I, the big Billy Goat Gruff,
said the Billy Goat. And his voice was as loud as the devil.
Now I'm coming to gobble you up,
roared the troll. Well, come along, said the big Billy Goat Gruff. I've got two horns and four hard hooves. See what you can do. So up climbed that mean ugly troll. And the big Billy Goat Gruff butted him with his horns, and he trampled him with his hard hooves, and he tossed him over the bridge into the rushing river. Then the big Billy Goat Gruff up the hillside to join his brothers. In the meadow, the three Billy Goat Gruffs got so fat that they could hardly walk home again. They are probably there yet. So, snip, snap, snap, this tail's pulled out. And kiddos, what we're gonna do is we're gonna do this one last time. Ready? One, two, ready, go.
Thank you.
was elegant.